What is the multiple barrier system? The multiple barrier system is a series of natural and engineered barriers that work together to isolate and contain used nuclear fuel to protect people and the environment. Hi, I'm Peter Keach. I'm the manager of engineered barrier science at NWMO. The first barrier that I'll describe is the fuel pellet itself. The next barrier is the fuel bundle. The third barrier I'll describe is the used fuel container. The fourth barrier is the clay exterior. And finally, I'll describe the host rock, which could be crystalline or sedimentary. The first barrier is the used fuel pellet itself. It's a solid ceramic material that's very stable. To make these, the mineral is mined in Canada and baked into this shape so that it will work in the nuclear reactor. Did you know that 9 of these pellets can produce enough electricity for a Canadian house for a full year? The pellets go inside the bundle when they go into the nuclear reactor. The second barrier is the fuel bundle, which is made up of a zirconium corrosion-resistant alloy, which is very durable. It holds the fuel pellets and is welded into a shape that optimizes it for the nuclear reaction so it can produce the electricity. Did you know that one of these bundles can power about 100 homes for a year? The third barrier is the used fuel container. I have a model of that right here. The real container is 2.5 meters long and weighs almost 3 tons. Inside the container, there are channels for the fuel bundles. The container holds 48 bundles. The container's made of steel, which is very strong, and the steel is welded shut prior to putting it in the repository. The heads on the end of the container are spherical, and they help to manage the pressure that'll develop in the repository. The very outer layer is copper, and that's put on to prevent corrosion. The used fuel container is put into the next barrier, which is the bentonite clay box. The fourth barrier is bentonite clay, which acts as a sealing system around the used fuel container. If it gets wet, bentonite will swell and seal any gaps around the container. It also prevents microbes from growing. Did you know that bentonite is used in many industries around the world, including for cosmetics and for food production? At the NWMO, we use 2 forms of bentonite. A box, as shown in this model, which is made up of dense bentonite, in which we carve a shape for the container. Here's a core from one of the actual boxes, and you can see that it's very sturdy. The other form of bentonite we use is a granulated bentonite, which is made up of different size particles of bentonite. This helps it flow into any of the gaps between the box and the rock. The fifth barrier is the host rock. The repository will be located at least 500 meters below surface, which is about as deep as the CN Tower is tall. The reason the repository is so deep is to help safely contain and isolate the used nuclear fuel away from people and the environment. The NWMO is looking at 2 types of rock: crystalline rock, which is found in the Canadian Shield, as well as sedimentary rock, which we find in southern Ontario. Did you know that the deep geological repository will be located where there are no other natural resources, so there won't be any future activities like mining? This will help us safely isolate and contain the used nuclear fuel and protect people and the environment for many generations to come. I hope you enjoyed hearing about the NWMO multi-barrier system. Learn more at nwmo.ca. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.